Hello friends, welcome to the video tutorial of ASP.NET MVC 5. In this video, we are going to study the concept of area. So let us see what is an area. So basically, area allows you to partition your large application into smaller units and where each unit contains separate MVC folder structure, same as the default MVC folder structure. Okay, so as we know, whenever we create an MVC application, what happens? The controller folder, view folder, model folders appear there. Similarly, when you create an MVC application and in that if you define an area, it also creates a same MVC folder structure for each and every area. Now, where it is useful? So whenever you are developing large enterprise application which may have a different modules like admin, finance, HR and marketing, in that case you can create an area. Definitely this is for separation of purpose. So as I told you, each area contains separate MVC folder structure for all these modules. And how you can create an area? So what you have to do, you have to right click on your project and say add area. So let us see this part practically. So here I already created one area demos project. Okay, so what you have to do, just right click over here, say add and then say area, just topmost menu. Then you have to specify the area name here. Suppose our website has two parts. One is handled by the admin and another is for the users of our website. So here I'll create one area for admin. Now look at here. See, this is your admin area. It has a controller, it has a model, it has a view. View has its own web.config file and plus admin area registration.cs file get added. So what is the purpose of this file? Definitely we are going to see. But let us add one more area that will be for the users of our website. So let us say add area. So I'm going to name it as client. Now look at here. So two areas get added, client and admin. Okay. Now admin has its own MVC folder structure and client also has its own MVC folder structure. Even you can delete this controller and model and views that appear outside your area if they are not of your purpose. Okay. Now let us see few more interesting things about area. Now each area will contain area registration class. And the name of that area registration class is nothing but your area name, and it is suffixed by this area registration word. Now, why this area registration class is required? Basically, this area registration class has a register area method, okay, that generally we override, and there we define the roots of our area. Okay, now basically, see. Before area, where we write our roots? We write our roots in root config file. Okay, or we did attribute routing. Okay, but whenever you start creating an areas, in that case, you have to define the roots of that area in separately, and that will be defined in your area registration file. Now, see, whenever you request for any action method. So definitely, how will you request? Now you have to request it like area slash controller slash method name. So whenever any URL that starts with an area name, that will be handled by the controllers included in the respective area folder structure under the area folder. So we are going to see this part practically. And finally, all the areas must be registered in application underscore start event in your global.asx.cs file. And for that, you have to give call to this method area registration.register all area. So let us see this thing practically. Now look at here. See, there is area registration file. And what is the name? Admin area registration means it is a concatenation of your area name plus area registration suffix. Okay, similarly there will be one more file in client area, which is client area registration, and these two files are open here also. Look at here. There is register area method where roots are defined. Okay, and this method is overridden by this admin area registration class. Actually, this code appears by scaffolding technique. Okay, area I didn't write anything here. When you create an area, at that time this code automatically appears and it is inherited from area registrations. And if you look at the URL pattern, look at the URL pattern. First of all, area name appear, then your controller name, then action name, and then after the ID or whatever the root parameter you are going to define. Similarly, see, look at the URL pattern for this client area. So client slash controller slash action slash ID. Okay, now what we will do, we will add some controller in both the areas and we will observe the URL. So as you can see here, I created two controllers in two areas. That is, in admin area I created data controller and in client area I created home controller. So as you can see here, in left hand side I added two methods also, index and about method, and I added respective view also, as you can see here. Okay, and I just displayed simple plain message. Now similarly, in my data controller also I added two methods, that is course and student, and two respective views are also created. Now let us try to execute this home controller's index action method. Okay, so I am executing it. See, it will show you an error because it is searching for an index view. Okay, and it might be present in a home controller, but no home controller is present at root level. It is present in our area. So how I have to request it? I have to specify the area name, which is nothing but a client, then home controller, and then index. Okay, so look at here. So every time whenever you want to request a URL, now you have to start with an area name. Suppose I want to call the about action method, so you will say about. Suppose you want to call the action method of admin area, so what you will say? Our area name is admin, then controller name is data controller, then we in that we created a course action method. So look at here. Similarly, suppose I want to execute student action method, so here I'll say student. Okay, now for admin admin part, it is okay to specify admin, then controller, then slash your action method. But for the client part, suppose you want to execute the home controller's index action method by default whenever nothing is specified in URL, so you have to create that URL pattern in your specific area registration class. So let us see this part. So here I'm going to open this client area registration file, and here I'm going to define the default root. Okay, now this is going to be a specific, that's why it should appear first. So context dot map root, then after you have to specify your root name, so say empty root, sorry, empty root, it can be any name but it should be unique, and it should be unique in all the areas. Remember this thing, multiple areas will not share a name because at the end these roots are going to be stored in your root table, so every root should have a unique name. Now you have to specify the URL pattern. So my URL pattern is what? My URL pattern is empty, so string dot empty. Okay, now whenever there is empty string, which index, which method I want to execute? So specify new, then controller is equal to home comma action is equal to index Then here you have to specify one more value, one more property, which is nothing but your area. Sorry, area is equal to what? Client. Okay, now let me give a semicolon here. Similarly, suppose you want to execute about method directly, so what you will say? Or whenever somebody says about, in that case home controller's about action method should get executed. So context dot map root, let me put a semicolon here. Specify your root name. Again, I'll repeat, it should be a unique name throughout your application. Then specify the URL pattern. My URL pattern is just about dash us. And then I'll specify, I'll map it on home controller. It should be in small case, controller is equal to home action is equal to about. We already created this action in our home controller, and area is equal to client. Okay, so let us try to execute it now. See, we didn't specify anything, so it should execute client area's home controller's index method. Look at here. Okay, so again it is quite easy. Every part is separated. You have to specify the roots of that area in that file, in that specific area registration file. Even I told you how to specify the default roots or how to configure the roots for that. Just one extra parameter get added in your anonymous class while mapping it. You have to specify the area property also. Okay, as we done it here. Okay, before defining the root in our root config file, we do not mention the area. But whenever you are defining it in your particular area registration file, you will specify the area also. If you are going to specify a specific roots like this, suppose you are for the blank string, you are going to map it on home controller's index action method. For about dash us, you are going to map it on home controller's about method of a client area. So let us try to execute about us part. So here I'll say slash dash about dash us. So look at here, it is executing, but definitely your admin root will not be executed because we do not configured it. So I hope you enjoy this video, and whenever you are going to develop any application, definitely you will start creating with an area first. You will partition your application and rest of the things will appear later. So if you have any doubts or comments, definitely you can write it to me. Thank you.